Okay, so I'm going to keep this video as unscripted as possible. This video is going to be about my new PC and the process of building it. After I show these video clips, I'm going to tell you the rest, you know, give you a bit of context on what happened. And it's a long story, so keep it short. Here are the two clips I have of it. Hey guys, Boom here, and today I am building my new PC. I got all these parts last night, and I was hoping today I could build them. So, first off, we have, if you watched my live stream, you'd know, Ryzen 5 1600, a good processor. Then we've got the Masterbox 5 by Course, Cooler Master. We have two sticks of 4 gig DDR4 RAM. This is by Crucial Ballistic Sport. It's kind of in the focus. Yeah, nice RAM. We've got the Corsair TX650M. It's a 650 watt modular power supply. Then we have the Seagate Barracuda 1 terabyte drive. This is from my old build. Well, my old computer. That's a GTX 970. I'm just going to be reusing it in this build. And then we have the Asus Prime X30 370 Pro, I guess. I don't know if it has RGB or not. I think that's just to say it's syncing all the stuff, which I don't have. And then we have Windows 10. And a lot of YouTubers recommended this, that you get a magnetic tray for all your screws and stuff. So I got that. And I got all this from Microcenter. Yeah, not sponsored. Like I'd ever get a sponsor. So yeah, I can't film myself building this, mainly because I don't have a tripod or anything. So I'm just going to get back to you once I'm finished with this build. Alright, so I got the CPU, RAM, and the cooler installed on my motherboard. Now it's time to move on to the case. And I've already been getting bags out, but this is just a checkpoint. And just to give you an update on how it's going. So after those two clips of footage, the rest of it got corrupted, so I couldn't do anything about that. Basically, the build went very well, except for the motherboard. The motherboard decided to fail on me, and we had to go back to the store and get a new one, replacement. That one worked, and I eventually got it all loaded up, got Windows installed. Sadly, the footage there got corrupted too. There's probably going to be a photo on the screen of my computer all built, so at least that didn't get corrupted. And yeah, it's a good build. Here are some benchmarks I'm going to put up in a minute. But yeah, the only thing that really went wrong with the build was the motherboard. So yeah, good job. So I was able to get some 3D Mark Time Spy results in for benchmarks, and they did pretty well, actually. They got just above a normal, like, HTC Vive gaming PC for virtual reality, and it just fell short of a gaming laptop, which in 2017 is pretty good, I would say. So yeah, those results are pretty good. The next benchmarks I ran were 3D Mark Firestrike and Skydiver. The Firestrike score was about the same as Time Spy, but the Skydiver score actually beat out the gaming laptop this time. So those were some of the synthetic benchmarks that I ran, but you might be asking what the performance is in actual games and gameplay-wise. In most games, I'm able to run about high settings, very high, to get a steady 60 frames with VSync on, and that's a big improvement over my last build, and I'm very happy with the performance I've gotten with this new build. And I'll be sure to put some gameplay up, and I'll be expecting more videos on gaming, because this new PC and the 6-core bonus of like the Ryzen 5, and Yeah, it's very good for recording gameplay and all that stuff, broadcasting. So yeah. And I'm editing this new video on the new build, so we'll see how that looks. Just gonna be a quick video I'm gonna be putting up on the PC build. So yeah, thank you for watching.